इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन इन इंडिया। द इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन एंटर्ड इंडिया इन 1854 व्हेन बॉम्बे ओपनड इट्स फर्स्ट स्टीम पावर्ड कॉटन मिल इन एशिया। इनिशियली द ग्रोथ वॉज स्लो एंड एक्सपेंशन ऑफ मॉडर्नाइज्ड कॉटन मिल वॉज नॉट डन अंटिल द एंड ऑफ 1870s एंड 1880s। In early industrial communities in India, the first successful mechanized textile mill was established in 1854. The industry flourished in the states of Maharashtra and Gujarat because of favorable humid climate, availability of raw material, and skilled labor. Factors that led to the industrialization in India. Geographical factors. These include raw materials, power supply, water, transport, labor, market, and climate. Commercial factors. These include capital, bank and credit facilities, government policies and organizational efficiency. Industrial regions of India. Mumbai Pune industrial region. This region owes its origin to the British rule in India. The opening of first railway track of 34 km between Mumbai and Thane in 1853, opening to of the Bhor and Thai ghats respectively to Pune and Nasik and that of Suez Canal in 1869, led to the development of Mumbai. The Hooghly Industrial Region, located in West Bengal. This region extends as a narrow belt running along the river Hooghly for a distance of about 100 km from Banasbari and Nai Hathi in the north to Birlalangar in the south. Industries have also developed in Midapur district in the west. The river Hooghly offered the best site for the development of an island river port as nucleus for the development of Hooghly region. Bangalore Tamil Nadu industrial region, spread in two states of Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. This region experienced the fastest industrial growth in the post-independence era. Till 1960, industries were confined to Bangalore district of Karnataka and Salem and Madurai districts of Tamil Nadu, but now they have spread all over the districts of Tamil Nadu except Viluppuram. Gujarat industrial region. The nucleus of this region lies between Ahmedabad and Vadodara, as a result of which it is also known as Ahmedabad-Vadodara industrial region. However, this region extends up to Valsad and Surat in the south and Jamnagar in the west. The region corresponds to the cotton growing tracts of the Gujarat plains, and the development of this region is associated with the location of textile industry since 1860s. So here is a map of India, major industrial regions of India. Jamshedpur. Before 1947, there was only one iron and steel plant in the country, Tata Iron and Steel Company Limited, TISCO. It was privately owned. After independence, the government took the initiative and set up several iron and steel plants. TISCO was started in 1907 at Sakchi, near the confluence of the rivers Subranakha and Karkai in Jharkhand. Later on, Sakchi was renamed as Jamshedpur. Geographically, Jamshedpur is the most convenient situated iron and steel center in the country. Sakchi was chosen to set up the steel plant for several reasons. This place was only 32 km away from Kalimati station and the Bengal-Nagpur railway line. It was close to the iron ore, coal and manganese deposit as well as to Kolkata, which provided a large market. TISCO gets coal and from Jharia coal fields and iron ore for limestone, dolomite and manganese from Odisha and Chhattisgarh. The Karkai and Subranakha rivers ensured sufficient water supply. Government initiative provided adequate capital for its later development. So here is the location of iron and steel industry in Jamshedpur. Ahmedabad. It is located in Gujarat on the banks of Sabarmati River. The first mill was established in 1859. It soon became the second largest textile city of India after Mumbai. Ahmedabad was therefore often referred to as The Manchester of India. Favorable locational factors were responsible for the development of the textile industry in Ahmedabad. Ahmedabad is situated very close to cotton growing areas. This ensures easy availability of raw material. The climate is ideal for spinning and weaving. The flat terrain and easy availability of land is situated for the establishment of the mills. The densely populated states of Gujarat and Maharashtra provide both skilled and semi-skilled labor. Well-developed road and railway network permits easy transportation of textiles to different parts of the country, thus providing easy access to the market. Mumbai port nearby facilities import to machinery and of machinery and export to cotton of cotton textiles. So here are the Indian textile industries of India. Thank you.